even on this farm, which I think we probably have evolved to, actually, we probably now have our own glyphosate-resistant marestail around here. I haven't tested it, but I think it probably is. But even on this farm where we spray, and again, when I say we, I mean somebody else, but
we, true,
mostly that guy sitting up in the tractor cab, but glyphosate in 2,4-D, we sprayed, pint of 2,4-D and 32 ounces or whatever, glyphosate at least. We sprayed sharpen at an ounce and glyphosate. At this farm, we had failures of our own. We didn't kill it. It looked terrible. It looked a lot like that kind of stuff, okay? And so it was a bad year. And so one of the things on page 3, I'll just point out, first of all, Dr. Laux at Ohio State is doing some of this work, but I think a lot of us weed scientists, academic weed scientists, are saying it looks more like this thing is changing its growth habit all the time. Okay, I don't even know what to call it anymore. I don't think it's a winter annual. Maybe it is, but it is tremendously adaptable. It usually comes up twice. It can germinate in the fall, it can germinate in the spring, but even now we're seeing it germinate in the middle of soybeans in July and August. And I don't really call that the fall. But so I don't know what it's doing there, but there's some people that are doing some work on that. It's probably the number one reason for fall herbicide applications in this state, and it works. Fall herbicide applications are generally, those are the guys that really are happy with their marestail control. If we have to go in an early spring pre-plant burn down, it needs to be early spring on smaller marestail. And I know what happened this year. We couldn't do that, and so we had a lot of failures. But it's the difference in, seeing that versus seeing this, okay? So one of the things you're going to drive by as we go out of here, we couldn't sign that study, this next study, but all of the treatments that you're going to drive by first were sprayed literally 30 days before all of the treatments that have marestail loaded in them. And so it just shows the effect of timing, okay? These were sprayed on May 13th, and we had sharpen in this plot, sharpen, metribuzin, which I like for marestail. It's cheap. And it has both foliar and residual activity. I think we can add that to a lot of our mixes. Sharpen, metribuzin, Roundup, where it went down here with some residua, but that's not doing anything too. So anyway, I mean, I'm not stopping here to go through all these treatments. I think the Roundup 2,4-D and metribuzin is a good option. I think the Sharpen, Roundup, and metribuzin, all of those things are good. We can talk about individual treatments and all of that, but the number one thing is timing. And I realize it's easier to say that than do it with the spring we had, but the number one thing is timing. And if you can get there, you'll see such a dramatic difference in the level of control. And the last thing I would say here is I have no recommendation for what to do with that in crop, okay? If it is Liberty Link soybeans, then I'll tell you to spray Liberty. But I have personally recommended bush hogging, brush hogging, and completely tilling the field, completely starting over this year, okay? If you do a brush hog, it's gotta be selective. You raise it up above the soybean. I do not have a recommendation. Maybe others do, but I don't believe we're going to kill that stuff in the crop. We have to kill it prior to planting. Any questions or comments?